As of November 2nd of 2025, there are currently 43 volcanoes which are actively erupting around the planet, a total which is 3 more than were erupting last week. One of these erupting volcanoes, which I commonly highlight in my weekly news segments due to its picturesque nature, is Guatemala's Fuego volcano. While Fuego has produced larger and more destructive eruptions such as in 1974 and 2018, the vast majority of its activity is several orders of magnitude less explosive. On average, Fuego produces a Volcanian explosion about once every 5 to 20 minutes, ejecting large lava bombs in a fairly wide radius, creating an ash plume, and sometimes also generating pyroclastic flows. And now, here are this week's top volcano-related news stories. In Alaska, a new, albeit brief, volcanic eruption occurred on a populated island, causing the Atka volcano's alert level to be raised. Meanwhile, in New Zealand, the infamous White Island volcano explosively erupted anew, marking the nation's first volcanic eruption in 2 months. And, in what is this week's top story, a highly unusual larger magnitude earthquake struck the Bárðarbungu volcano within Iceland's largest ice sheet. This earthquake struck at the volcano's summit at 4:46 p.m. on October 29th, registering in as a magnitude 5.4. This represented the largest earthquake to have struck the landmass of Iceland in 4 years, but due to its remote location, it caused no damage. But what made this earthquake so interesting? Typically, diagrams termed as moment tensors are used to represent a top-down view of fault movement where the white moves towards the blue. More than 99.9% of all earthquakes fall into these 5 categories, so where any of the remaining 3 categories of quakes are observed, it is a bit unusual. Explosions indicate expansion in all directions, vertical P CLVD quakes indicate universal subsidence, and vertical T CLVD quakes indicate universal uplift. The 5.4 earthquake that struck was a vertical T CLVD type quake, which indicated rapid uplift on a section of its summit piston type caldera. For multiple years now, Bárðarbungu has been undergoing a slow and long-term uplift caused by the accumulation of magma in its magma chamber. Thus, it appears that more molten rock for a time was present than could normally fit in a section of its magma chamber, causing displacement to accommodate the new material via a path of least resistance, in this case straight upwards. Thus, there is now slightly more room for magma to accumulate, and assuming that the magnitude 5.4 quake uplifted the entirety of Bárðarbungu's caldera, the amount it rose would have been around 5.5 centimeters or 2.2 inches. Of course, it is also possible that only a smaller section of the caldera rose during this quake. Regardless, it is not indicative yet of any true signs of strong unrest, so this volcano is remaining at a green alert level. Meanwhile, in Alaska, a new volcanic eruption began at the Atka volcano on October 29th. This small phreatic eruption occurred 12 miles north-northeast of the small town of Atka, population 50, at 9:27 p.m. local time, specifically originating from its Korovin cone. Korovin is the most active vent of the overall volcanic complex, which consists of 4 stratovolcanoes and 2 satellite stratocones. In historic times, only 20 eruptions have been observed, 3 from Klyuchev, which last erupted in 1995, and 17 eruptions from Korovin. This week's activity marks the 3rd brief eruption to occur here this year, perfectly fitting the description of a small VEI-1 phreatic eruption. While more explosions could follow during the next few days to weeks, this is far from a certainty. While the Korovin vent has not shown any signs of life since, Atka's alert level was raised from green to yellow on the same day as its eruption. And, in New Zealand, the White Island volcano 52 kilometers north-northeast of the city of Whakatane has been intermittently erupting at a low intensity since May of last year. This activity has waxed and waned, and after no eruption since late August, White Island erupted again on October 30th, sending a minor amount of ash upwards in a volcanic plume. This occurred at 12:30 p.m. and then again at 6:40 p.m. on that day, and as a result, White Island's alert level was raised from 2 to 3. Here is a quick list of all the world's volcanoes which are currently erupting. Additionally, here are some volcanoes showing signs of unrest which are not erupting as of the recording of this video on November 1st of 2025. As a final note, I would like to thank my YouTube channel member, MindZ, for supporting my work.